Hey guys, so today I want to do just a super chill video and just kind of do a full face of makeup. I wanted to show you guys a bunch of products that I've been loving at the moment, so it's kind of like a favorites video even though we're in the middle of February, but just super simple, just hanging out, doing my makeup, and talking about some products that I've really been liking. So if you want to hang out and just kind of chill and get ready with me, let's do it. So I already have my brows on, and I've been using a mix of two products recently. I've been using the Benefit Foolproof Brow Powder with the Precisely My Brow Pencil. I like that the powder gives my brows a softer look than if I were to just go in with this guy, so I've been doing a little bit of both. Okay, let me get my hair back for some face makeup. Okay, for primer, I've been liking the Benefit Porefessional Hydrating one. I've always really liked the original Porefessional. I like the Pearl one that came out like 2 years ago, and then when I saw this hydrating one, of course I just had to try it. My skin type is more normal to dry, so this is right up my alley. I find that it does fill in my pores and it does feel kind of nice and cooling and hydrating. And I bought the mini size of it to see if I really like it, and I do, so I might buy the full size when I run out, we'll see. Okay, I have two foundations I've been loving at the moment. One is the Bite Changemaker Foundation. I think I used this on camera for the first time, right? I love this for a more natural skin day. It literally looks like skin on me. I freaking love it. But today I'm gonna go in with another favorite, which is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Dewy Foundation. This foundation gives me the most beautiful finish. Like the first time I wore it, I was just shocked. I loved it. So I think I have two shades that might match me. I have a little bit of a tan on right now. I feel like either could work. I'm gonna do soft beige. The one thing I don't like about this is the applicator. It's one of those like spatula kinds. So I mean, I just wipe it on my own face because I'm the only one using this product, but I would prefer a tube or a pump. And then I'm gonna use my Practic foundation sponge for this. So I have been testing the Tati Beauty Blendiful ever since my first video with it, my first impressions, and I have a love-hate relationship with the Blendiful. I like the finish it gives my skin. It does make products like my concealer go on really, really nicely, but I still get fuzzies on my face. I have washed it probably like 3 or 4 times now, and I still get little gray fuzzies every time I use it, and that just really turns me off from the sponge because, you know, I don't want fuzzies on my face as I'm trying to do my damn makeup. So that's my dilemma with the Blendiful. Let me know if you guys are still liking it. I know a lot of you guys in my comments did like it. Some people didn't understand it. There's kind of a mix of opinions on the Blendiful. I am filming super early today. It's 9:43 in the morning. Usually I film around noon, but Peter has been wanting to start going to the gym with me in the mornings, and I normally go around like 7, but he has a normal job and has to work, so he needs to go at 5 a.m. So today was our first time going together at 5 a.m. and now I'm like, I have all day. What am I supposed to do all day? So I have like 3 extra hours in my day and I don't know what to do with all this free time, you know? That's kind of why I'm doing a full face of makeup today, because I got the time. Doesn't this foundation look good? Like, it doesn't even look like I'm wearing foundation. I'm gonna add just a little bit more. So for my workouts, I've been following Brett Contreras's program, which is called Booty by Brett. He's the guy that invented the hip thrust, and so far I've really, really been liking his program. I'm on my 8th week of doing Booty by Brett, and I love his program style. Last year in 2019, I followed Abby Pollock's program and then Stephanie Buttermore's program for like the whole year. And I like Brett's style a lot more. It's so funny saying Booty by Brett. So Booty by Brett is a full body 3 times a week with 2 additional glute days. And I really like the 3 times a week because I tried doing 5 days a week of heavy lifting last year and I was just exhausted all the time trying to do full body every single day. I'm adding some concealer to my spots. But Brett kind of focuses more on a lower volume because he kind of says that a lot of women will just try to go way too hard in the gym. And so his days kind of consist of, I think it's like 6 exercises total each day. And then you just do it. It's full body, but it's definitely glute focused, which I love. And I'm just having so much fun following his programs and getting stronger and stronger each week. I do post some of my workout stuff on my Instagram. If you don't follow me there, it's just Angela Bright. I'll post on my stories like a workout I'm doing or my outfit or my butt looks good or something, you know? My favorite lift at the moment is bench press for sure. Oh my gosh. I literally look forward to bench pressing every single day. I hit a PR of 100 pounds last week for bench, which I'm super proud of. So I'm just like working on my strength there, getting some gains, you know? Ooh, it's so fun. I get so excited. How did I go off on this tangent? Oh yeah, Peter wants to go to the gym. Yeah, so Peter finally decided, like, he wants to start working out again. So I bought him a program from Jeff, is it Capillier? His YouTube is Athlene X. Maybe you've heard of him if you are into lifting, I don't know. But yeah, I'm just excited to be going to the gym with Peter, and now I have all this extra time in my day, so maybe I'll do longer videos, I don't know. I'm gonna do under eye concealer with the CoverGirl True Blend. That's kind of light, because I have a tan on. I might mix that with something. Okay, I'm gonna mix that with this Kylie Cosmetics Concealer in Hickory. This one has like a peachy undertone to it. So I do mix this with some of my concealers, because it kind of helps correct a little bit. And then still using my Practic sponge. Okay, I need to know, would you guys be interested in seeing any like fitness type videos from me? I don't know, like my favorite workout clothes, like what's in my gym bag. I don't know, like things like that, because, you know, because lifting is like a huge part of my life right now and I love it and I love spending time in the gym, and so I kind of want to share that with you guys, but I don't know if you guys want to see that, because I'm obviously a makeup channel, but it would be fun for me to share other aspects of my life, you know? I could do like a vlog style video, like go to the gym with me, you know what I mean? So I don't know, let me know if you guys would be interested in seeing that. It'd be totally different for me to film that kind of video, but please let me know. I'm gonna set my under eyes with my RCMA powder, and for this I do use the Baby Blendiful, because this guy does not shed. At least it hasn't shed on me yet. So I take the little butt of the heart, dip that in my powder, then I just press on my under eyes. I just find that this does a really, really good job at setting my concealer in place, and it helps me crease less. I mean, I still crease a tiny bit. I mean, who doesn't? And then this little Blendiful I won't wash all the time, just because this is the only step I use it for, so I'm not too worried about that. So I'm just really pressing this into my under eyes. Yeah, and it looks so smooth. And then I'll just bring some on my lid too. And then I'm gonna press a little bit of this powder kind of into my pores, right here, the center of my cheek, and around my nose. Just like this whole center area right here on my forehead lines. I got this flavor LaCroix and I really don't like it. It's the Pamplemousse flavor. Not my favorite. I think the Raz Cranberry is my favorite flavor as of now. What is your guys' favorite LaCroix or sparkling water flavor? I like lime too. Lime's just a good go-to one, you know? But this Pamplemousse one, like, what even is Pamplemousse? I don't know. And now I like to set the rest of my face with my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Luminous Light. And I'm using a Sigma F25. So this I will press, like, all along my cheek area. Pretty much just everywhere except my under eyes. This just gives a nice little glow to the skin, and I like how it looks underneath my bronzer and my blush. And it also does kind of set your foundation in place and gets it ready for that blush and contour, so. Alright, for my blush, I've really been liking this KVD blush in Foxglove. This is brand new from their line. Or I should call this the Kindness Vegan Beauty Discovery Doing Good Vegan Beauty brand. Oh my god. If you don't know, Kat Von D is no longer associated with KVD Beauty anymore. So she has no say in the brand, she has no royalties, no nothing. She is gone from this brand, so therefore, I wanted to buy a blush, so I did. If you don't know what I'm talking about, KVD Vegan Beauty posted a little post on the Instagram and it's like, KVD doesn't stand for someone's initials. It stands for Kindness Vegan Beauty Doing Good Discovery Vegan Beauty. And I'm like, oh my god. I just like to make fun of that, I think it's hilarious, but I'm excited to be using their products again because I love the tattoo eyeliner. I know so many people did. I liked using the brown one a lot for my eyebrows, so maybe I'll do that again. I don't know, but here we are. This is the shade Foxglove, and for my brush, I'm gonna use the Sigma F37. This is my new favorite blush brush. It's kind of like a smaller version of this brush I just used to kind of set my whole face, but it's like so soft and fluffy and flimsy. Taking this on my cheeks. Sometimes I bronze first, but I guess today I'm doing blush first. It's fine. isn't this a pretty color? They have a paler one too. I think that will be really pretty when I have no tan on, so maybe I'll have to pick that one up as well. But yeah, I've just been wearing this blush a lot. I think it's a super pretty just everyday color. And it's not overly pigmented, which I like in a blush, and it's completely matte. Okay, and then my favorite bronzer at the moment is the Hourglass Nude Bronze Light Bronzer. I'm gonna use a Sigma F05. Just kind of bronze slash contour. Nothing too crazy. And I'm gonna take a little bit of that on this Praktik small blend brush and just do a little tiny nose contour. Nothing crazy. And then I like to bring that kind of in here to contour. This is still my nose, but I like to have a little contour right in here because I don't think I'm gonna wear much eyeshadow today. I don't really like to wear eyeshadow on a daily basis. I really just wear it when I'm filming, which is kind of funny. And I'm just gonna pat over my blush and contour with my sponge. Now I'm gonna take a lighter shade of the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. I'm gonna take Incandescent Light, which is this middle shade from this trio. I'm taking a Sigma F35, and I'm gonna place this kind of where I would highlight, but a little bit more all over the place. This just kind of helps brighten the entire cheekbone area. And then I also feel like this helps blend my blush kind of into my under eye color, you know? It just makes a smoother transition. It's like a blending shade, you know? We blend. For my highlighter, I'm gonna go into my Jaclyn The Flash palette. I think I'm gonna mix these two top shades together. This is a Sigma F03, and I'm just gonna do a little bit right here. I really like the formula of the highlighters in this palette, but I feel like the shades are like almost too bright. Like, is that even a thing? It's like no matter what shade I use, it just looks like white on my skin. And I like more, you know, like her Champagne Pop highlighter has like that kind of peachy hint to it. And these are just straight up light, but they look good on the skin, I feel like, you know? It's pretty. Okay, patting over that again with my sponge. Okay, let me take my hair down. Is this contour blended? No. I think I want to dye my hair lighter for summer. I've been working on growing out my roots, so my roots are probably about like here right now. You can see it's like, it's a little bit lighter than the rest of my hair, but my hair is like, it's so dark back here. I just want to like lighten everything up, make it look like my natural color, and maybe add some like blonde highlights or something. I have done so many hair colors in the past, so I love playing with different colors in my hair. I have gone all blonde before. I wouldn't do that again, but like some blonde highlights for sure. So like I said, I really don't wear eyeshadow on a daily basis. I just throw on some mascara, some lashes, I call it good. I mean, like I'll highlight my eyes, but like I really don't do anything. But I guess I'll just add like a crease color, right? All right, so of course I've been liking the new Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 palette, so I'm gonna take G Money on an E25. Okay, and I'm just gonna throw this kind of in my outer crease and a little on my outer lid. That'll probably be it. I did do one everyday look with this palette where I used some shades from the top row, so if you wanna see that, I'll link that down below for you. And then of course I did do a really crazy, fun, kind of reddish purpley look with this palette. I'm definitely planning on doing more looks with this palette, so don't you worry. And I'm just gonna add a little bit of G Money to my lower lash line. Again, focusing it on the outer corner. All right, I'm gonna go pop on some mascara and lashes and I'll be right back. Okie dokie, I popped on lashes, it took me forever. I use Velour lashes, it can't be tamed. And these are super pretty, good for a little natural everyday look. And when I'm wearing minimal eye makeup like this, I don't like to put mascara on my lower lash line, I just leave it nice and blank, and it has a little bit of shadow on there, but nothing crazy. For lips, I have this random lipstick that I've been loving recently. It is this CoverGirl lipstick. The shade is 435 Speaker. It's a demi matte. Let me show you. Does that look exactly like my lip color? Like, did you even see anything go on? Am I just crazy? Okay, but yeah, like, it's pretty, right? I think it was sometime last year, CoverGirl sent me, like, 50 lipsticks, and I was like, I don't need all of these. So about a month or two ago, I was going through all of them to donate the ones that I haven't swatched or used yet. And then I came across this one, and I was like, that looks promising. I swatched it. Most beautiful thing ever. So it's just like a really pretty pinky nude color. And then on top of that, I'm going to take the Fenty Beauty Gloss in Glass Slipper. I can't find my Sweet Mouth one, the lighter pink shade. I already lost it, and I bought it like 2 weeks ago. So we're going to do this one instead. This is the glossiest gloss in the world. Like, my lips look so wet when I have this on, but I love it. I think I do want mascara on my lower lash line. Who am I? I also made a mess. I'm gonna let that dry and then I'll take that off with a Q-tip. I do wanna put on some clear brow gel though. So I'm just gonna use my Benefit 24-hour brow setter. Okay, one more thing. I'm gonna set my face with the Pixi Glow Mist. I freaking love this spray so much. Does not taste good. Okay, and here is my final makeup look. I have done this look 20,000 times on my channel, but I just wanted to show you some products I've been loving recently. And this is also my go-to look if I need to wear makeup that day and just wanna look nice and put together. My skin looks so good right now. Let me show ya. Here's kind of what my skin looks like up close. Nice and glowy. Let me know if you've tried any of these products that I used today. What are your current favorites? I love to know what you guys are loving too. And I hope you guys enjoy this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.